Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making spaghetti with Italian sausage and peppers. And right here I have prepared part of the sausage. You can see the package it came out of. This is hot Italian sausage. And it's 18 ounces, 1 pound and 2 ounces. If you want to just use a pound, that would be fine. And these will come in links like this that have casings, or at least this did, yours might not. But we want about, I'd say I'm using these shears to cut a half inch worth, but it's pretty thick through. So you can see that these are like little sausages that I'm going to be putting on the stove in just a minute and browning up. So this is not a case where I'm trying to crumble the sausage. I think it's going to be nice to have those little meaty bites in the sauce that goes with our spaghetti. So I'm just showing you the last one. I'd already done the other ones ahead of time. So I'm going over to the stove and I have my stirrer here. I'm going to turn this on, and then it's going to take me a minute or two to get these browned up. I'm not going to stir them really roughly or very hard because, like I said, I'm not trying to get these crumbled. I want to maintain the shape, so I'll just kind of move them aside as they brown along the bottom, and I'll turn them as they need to be turned. So I'll be back when these are done, and we'll continue with our recipe. My Italian sausages are done. You can see they're nice little sort of like meatballs, but they're sausage, and there is some grease there in the bottom. What I'm going to do, and this is what people typically do in this situation, is remove those sausages, and I always drain them on a paper towel like this to remove any excess fat. But I'm going to be sauteing some vegetables, and there is some fat that is left from the sausage. Just the sausage drippings, and I can use that to saute my vegetables. So what I'm going to do is come over here to my counter. Let me turn that off. And you'll see there's just a little bit of pan drippings, so it's not extremely unhealthy. I have two green peppers that have been chopped up, and you can see the dimensions are about a half inch wide. Oops, the right one on the floor. And it could be an inch or inch and a half long, just what it turned out to be as it was being chopped. Two of those, two green bell peppers, two red bell peppers, and two medium-sized onions. And you can see they're chopped kind of in a similar fashion, just whatever comes out when you make a slice that's about an inch and a half long. So all of those are going into this skillet, into the pan drippings. And it's going to be very colorful, but what we need to do is to get them done. So we're going to put them back on the stove and saute them until they are soft. They will still have a lot of color, but they will be soft and we'll be ready to start putting this together as a dish. So here we go. This is what your vegetables will look like when they have come off the stove. You'll see that the onions are clear and the peppers are getting soft. So now you're ready to combine this whole mixture that's going to be the sauce for your spaghetti. So here we have the Italian sausage, and you can see there's quite a bit of grease that is been absorbed by the paper towel, so I'm just going to put those in. That was the 18 ounces worth, or you can use a pound, whatever. And then to that, I'm going to add some nice pre-made sauce. You can make your own homemade, but I don't do that. I just go ahead and get something convenient, something easy and quick, and something I enjoy. I'm very familiar with this brand, Prego, and I've chosen traditional, and what we call this is Italian sauce. So you use it on anything that's Italian. This is 24 ounces, so that's probably not going to be quite enough. So I'm going to pour that in. And then just to make this a little bit different, instead of using more of the very same kind of sauce, I'm going to use something that's called pizza sauce. And this is 14 ounces. So you notice the 24 ounces and the 14 ounces, whatever that totals to, any kind of Italian sauce that you want to use, just get approximately that much. You might find it in 16-ounce jars, if so, two of those would be fine. Just enough to give some really good coverage here. And then when we get all of this together, we're going back to the stove with it, and we're going to simmer it for 10 minutes. And I'll get started on this and show you what my next step is going to be. So let me just combine this a little bit. Doesn't that look good? It's going to be a very good topping, but it has to cook a little bit. So back to the stove and turn it on low. And you'll see that my water has come to a boil over here. And this is in a Dutch oven. It's about half full of water, maybe not quite half. To that water, I added some extra virgin olive oil, just a dollop, tablespoon or so. And I added about a teaspoon of salt. I want to have the spaghetti salted, and the olive oil is to keep it from sticking together and also from sticking to the pot, even though that is a non-stick pot. So I have a package here, which is 8 ounces, and it just depends on what you feel like. If you want more, I think we'll have enough sauce for more. But for us, the 8 ounces is fine. You can put them in like this, or you can break them in the middle. I think it's more manageable if you just break them and drop them like that. Then you won't have to curve them around. But we're going to let that cook, and it won't take very long because I'm cooking it until it's chewy. So it will be al dente. But when that's done, this will probably be done, and we'll serve it up on a big platter. My spaghetti is cooked until it is al dente. You can sort of tell by the color. It's still a little bit yellow. So I'm going to turn that off. And then I need to drain it. So I'm coming over to the sink, and I've already put a colander right there so it can drain down into the sink. And then what I'm going to do is just shake that a little bit, get the water off of it, and then return it to this pan, bring it over to my workspace, put it on the counter there, and then we're going to be spreading it out in a big platter. You'll need a large space for this particular dish. Now, I will say that I was a little light on making the spaghetti. Used 8 ounces. This would probably do a pound's worth. So I will probably be using maybe just half of the sauce. We'll see how that goes. If this is drained enough, I think it is, we'll just pour it out here. Just pour it out in your large platter. And then if you have something to spread it out a little bit, you can make it look nicer. And I have to keep in mind all the time when I'm making these demonstrations for you that my husband and I are the ones who are stuck eating all of this. So if it doesn't freeze really, really well, which, for example, the spaghetti wouldn't, although the sauce would, if it doesn't freeze very well, then we have to eat it very quickly. But anyway, there is our base. I'm going to go over here and pick up our sauce. It's been simmering about 10 minutes, and it's nice and done. And I'm just going to set it down there and let you take a look at it. And then I'm going to be spooning it over the top just as much as I feel like we need. I don't think we need all of it, but if we do, I'll use it all. I'll go down the center and then try to get around the edges. I can be very generous with this because it is quite a bit of sauce. When you put that many peppers together with that much sausage and then those jars of sauce mix, you have quite a lot. I think that's really good for us because it leaves enough for another nice meal, and I can just freeze this, thaw it later. It'll be great over any kind of pasta. Now the next thing I need to do is put some cheese over the top. And what I have is pecorino Romano cheese. And I've grated it using just a kitchen grater, this part right here. And it comes out nicely like this. You just want to put a nice grating. This was about a half cup. If you like more or less, then just adjust to your liking. And then there's one more thing I'm going to do, and that's put some chopped parsley on the top. And I have some right here, and I want to show you. This actually came from my herb garden this year. On the very last day that I thought that we would have decent weather and not freezing temperatures at night, I harvested all my herbs and washed them and did what I could with freezing some of them, and some of them just don't really freeze. But I put a lot of parsley in a refrigerator. We have two refrigerators, and one is downstairs in the basement. We keep it closed all the time because it's just for storage. And I still have fresh parsley coming from it. So all I do is just kind of take scissors and snip that. And you can see I have about a third of a cup right there. Just put what you want. Just take your fingers and sprinkle it over the top. And that makes a wonderful dish. And I don't have any bread made to go with it right now, but I would suggest that you use some French or Italian bread and maybe a green salad, and it's going to be a wonderful dinner.